Hello everyone, and welcome to a relaxing ASMR video dedicated to chess. I have been playing chess off and on for about, I guess, 30 years of my 40 years on this planet. Of course, 41 years old as of the date of this video. My oldest brother, of which I have two, introduced me to the game of chess back around the, I would guess the late 70s or early 80s. And I have been playing off and on ever since. So this video is dedicated to anyone out there who enjoys the game or is new to the game. So whether you're new, or actually I should say, no matter what your experience level is, we're just going to talk about the game as if we're all somewhat new to it. Go over the pieces and some gameplay examples. Maybe some basic strategies. And two key moves. I think the only two key moves that I know of. Castling. And the en passant, if I think that's how you pronounce it. It's a French term for in passing. So why don't we just take out all these pieces, and then we'll talk about each one. As we go through here. The game of chess is played between two people. One plays light, and the other plays dark. Black and white, brown and tan, whatever the colors may be. One is light, the other is darker. And the light color always goes first. Each side has 16 pieces. And we'll be talking about each piece once I get them all out. game of chess actually dates back, I believe, almost 2,000 years, or at least 1,000. I believe it originated somewhere in the Middle East, and then worked its way towards Europe. But I'm no expert. Just give me a moment while I set the board up here so we can see. Okay. Now, all right. So, I'll set the board up as if you are my visiting opponent. And you can be white. And then I'll play as the darker set or the darker pieces. So, as we said, each person playing has, each player has 16 pieces, which consist of 8 pawns. And, well, before we go over the pieces, I want to talk about the board. The board is broken up into 64 squares, 8 ranks, and 8 files. I'm not an expert, and I don't play by rank and file, but I believe the ranks go this way, numbers 1 through 8, and the files go across. So, and the lightest square of the rank and file facing you goes in the right corner. So you would not have the board with this dark square in this corner. And that's pretty much the basics of the chess board layout. This set is a modest chess set that you can purchase at any retail, big box, online store. It's fairly inexpensive, and as you may tell, takes quite a beating. Okay, so why don't we start by laying out the pieces? As we said earlier, there are 16 pieces for each player. And we'll start with the pawns. The pawns are the lowest ranking piece, but are not least powerful, or I guess you could say powerful to a degree. They are still very important pieces. Each piece is very important, but the pawns are by no means weak just because they are termed pawns or the lowest ranking. They still pose quite a threat and are used to position one's self in the beginning of the game to set one's own I'm not really quite sure how to word it, but pretty much the beginning first 10 moves or so can decide the outcome of the game or the way it's going to be played. And the pawns pretty much decide that, the position of the pawns. So, I'll lay out your 16 pieces for you. And as I said, we'll start with the pawns. The pawns go on the second rank from you. So this would be your first rank and second rank. Although, again, I'm not an expert, but the ranks do go, they are numbered. So if this is 8, then this would be 7. Or this would be 1 and 2. I'm not, again, not sure which way the ranks go. If one starts from the light side or the dark side. Dark side. Anyway, the pawns go on this row. Second row from facing you, I guess you would say. So that would be your 8 pawns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Next would be the rooks, which are sometimes referred to as the castles. One in each corner. Next would be the knights. I'm just saying next pretty much based on rank, but you can set the chessboard up however you like. I'm just going through this way, by order of rank, pretty much. The knights would go next. Of course, the knights are like horses. Next would be the bishops. Next to the knights. The queen would be next, and the queen always goes on her, on the square, her colored square. Since she's a light piece, she would go on the light square. If you were playing dark or black pieces, you would put her on the dark square. Like so. Queen always goes on the square of her color. And then the king. So you're all set up. I'm gonna go ahead and set up my side now. Starting with my 8 pawns. And then my rooks. And then the knights. bishops would be next. The queen, again, on the same color that she is. And then the king. Okay. Actually, what I think I'm going to do is to turn the chessboard around because it looks like, because the dark pieces are further away from the camera, they look kind of hard to distinguish. So I'm going to turn them around so they are facing, they are on your side. So just bear with me a second. There, I think that's better, don't you? Great. Let's just set that up so it looks fairly straight and even. Alright. So I guess this means I'll have to go first. Sorry about that. Anyway. Alright. So, why don't we walk through basically the movements of each piece. Pawns can move on their first move, can move one or two squares. Or two squares, I guess you would say. Or two spaces. Pawn can move one or two. And for the beginning of the game, it's usually important to move these pawns up two spaces. Because the object of the game is to pretty much obtain control of the center board for the most part. Again, I'm not a grandmaster or an expert, but you pretty much, once you maintain control here with one pawn, he controls these two squares, and then from there you can build your defense or your attack. Anyway, so many different strategies there are in this game. I won't pretend to know all of them, but so back to the movements. The pawns, when they move, their very first move, they can move two squares. Now, a pawn can capture any piece that is diagonally of the same rank and file that the pawn is on. So, for instance, if the pawn is here, it can capture any piece that would be here, no matter the rank. Any piece can capture any other piece so long as it's a legal move. So if a queen was here and my pawn was here and my opponent or you moved your queen here, I would capture your queen. However, pawns can only move straight one square at a time after their first move. So while they can move two spaces their first turn, after that they can only move one. They can attack. They can attack on the diagonal, but cannot move or attack horizontally or vertically, and cannot move backward. every other piece on the board can move forwards or backwards except the pawns. A pawn can also be promoted to any other piece. For example, if a pawn is here, if my pawn is here, and I move to the opposite rank, the very last rank from where I started, on my opponent's rank, their first rank, I can then promote my pawn to a queen. Anything from a pawn to a queen. So that's the basics of the pawn. And now the rook. The rook moves horizontally along the rank or vertically along the file. Well, maybe the best way to say that would be the rook can move any amount of spaces vertically or horizontally. Cannot move over or jump over pieces, and cannot move diagonally. So a rook can move here, can move here, or can move in one move there. Any number of horizontal or vertical spaces, and can capture the end, any piece. Oops, I took off the felt at the bottom so we could enjoy the tapping of the pieces. So if a pawn was here and my rook was here, I could capture that piece. The knight. The knight can move to any rank or file that is not of its same color and is not on the same rank or file that it is on. So sounds a little confusing, but basically the knight can move two squares horizontally and then one square vertically, or two squares vertically and one square horizontally. For example, if my knight was here, I would move one, two, and then either this direction or that direction. And as you can see, one, one, two, and one, this square here is not on the same rank or file as where I started. Again, these are the ranks, and these are the files, unless I have them mixed up. But so this is not the same file that I was on, nor the same rank. I may not be explaining that very well, but basically he can move by on any square not the same color that he's on, and that is not the same rank or file. So what that means is here, 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 and here. So he can move that. There. There. And like we already said, there. So the night is the pretty powerful to a degree piece, capable of attacking pieces that other pieces might not be able to. So, let's use an attack as an example. Let's say there is a pawn here and a bishop there. I could capture either one. One, two, and one. Take out that bishop, or that pawn, one, two, there. Okay, now for the bishops. Bishop can move any number of squares diagonally on its same color square. So it cannot, if it's a dark, if it's on a dark square, it will always remain on that dark colored squares, on those dark colored squares, and can only move diagonally. So, if I started here, let's move this pawn out of the way, move this one out of the way, the bishop can move to there, any number of squares, cannot jump over pieces. The only pieces capable of jumping over other pieces are the knights. So for instance, an example of an attack would be a pawn here. Bishop moves. And captures that pawn. If my pawn is here, my bishop would stop there. Cannot move any further because that piece is blocking his movement. That is the same for all pieces. Your own pieces cannot jump over your own pieces. It's not like checkers. Except again for the knight. So if the knight starts here, if your knight is here, he would be able to go one, whoops, two, and move there. Or move there. Okay? So that explains the bishops. Next would be the queen. Again, queen cannot jump over any piece. Queen can move any direction, any number. Of squares. And lastly, the king. The king can move only one square at a time. any direction, diagonally, horizontally, vertically, forwards or backwards. Again, only the pawns must move forwards. They cannot move backwards. Now, there are two special moves. I think the only two moves in the game that are called special moves. At least, they're the only two that I know about. The first one is called castling. It is the only time the king can move two spaces, more than one space. When the knight, or actually I should say, when the pieces between the king and the rook on either side, actually, instead of me showing you from my end of the game of the board, we'll do from your side. Castling is when the king can move two spaces and the rook is put on the other side of the king, like so. It is somewhat of a means of defense. But there are a couple caveats. Number one, the king and the rook engaged or about to enter castling cannot have previously moved. It must be their first move. So, the rook cannot have already moved, nor can the king. Second, the king cannot pass through or onto a space that would be attacked by another player. So, for instance, let's say that there is your opponent's knight here. This piece can attack this space. The king cannot castle because that space is under attack. The king cannot move through that space. Likewise, if your opponent's rook was there, the king could not castle here because the king will be put into a state of attack or check. However, the rook can use castling as a means of escape, and those same rules do not apply. Again, no pieces must be between the rook or the king. And the third caveat, or rule, is that the king cannot be in check. And again, cannot be place itself into a state of check by moving into castling or by performing castling. So, for instance, your opponent's knight was here and put you into a state of check. You could not escape check by castling. You will need to do something else. Of course, the king is always moves two spaces, so two here. Or castle this way. the rook always goes on the opposite side. So it really all depends on your strategy. Have you played their first pieces? You wouldn't want to castling is pretty much a means of defense. So if you are open here like this, or some of your pieces were missing on this side, you wouldn't really want to castle over here, because it leaves your king open to attack far easier than it would be if he castled. Whoops. Like so. See? The king is behind three pawns. The rook on that side, and is pretty much in a very good defensive posture or stance. So that is castling. The other movement is called the en passant. ENPASSANT. It's French. It means in passing. So, what does that mean? It means that if you have a pawn anywhere on the board, and your opponent's pawn moved two spaces to get next to you, you can capture it in passing, en passant. That is because, from as I understand it, since your pawn can attack diagonally, the same colored rank and filed squares, one space diagonally in front of it, the opponent, by moving two squares, is actually passing through that attack square. That is why you can move, attack it in passing. In passing. But it has to be that opponent, your opponent's, when that pawn moves, it's two squares its first time. So if you happen to get a pawn down, I guess, to your opponent's fourth rank, it can capture it. I don't think I've ever performed that move. I just actually looked that up not too long ago. Okay. So, and of course, if I haven't explained it yet, the object of the game is to put your opponent's king into a state of checkmate, which is a state of inescapable capture, so that the king cannot move anywhere to escape from being captured, and the piece or pieces that put the king into a state of checkmate cannot be captured either. So, for instance, if, let's just say, there's your king, and I have my bishop here. And I have, oh, it will be a good piece. I have a knight here. And I have a rook, a queen here. Okay. That piece would be in checkmate. Let's just get rid of this pawn and this pawn. This bishop. Your piece would be in checkmate. Cannot move here because my queen would be able to capture it. Cannot move here because my bishop would be able to capture. Cannot move there, of course, because the queen. And where did I have the king? Here. Cannot move there, cannot move. Cannot, king cannot move anywhere to escape checkmate. Once a piece has moved to where your king can be captured, it's in a state of check. So let's just reset the board. Let's say I had my knight here. You would be in check because my knight could capture your king. But it's not checkmate because your pawn could capture my knight. And thus, your king escapes checkmate or check. Your knight could capture my knight. So usually check happens first, unless it's pretty obvious that the king cannot escape the check, or the pieces putting the king in check cannot be captured, thus creating checkmate. If there is also called stalemate, and stalemate is when the king keeps, or both kings, keep evading check and cannot be put into a state of checkmate. The game just goes on and on and on, and there's no end, and it pretty much becomes a point of stalemate. That is pretty much the basics of the game of chess. Why don't we go through just a sample game of chess to show you some beginning opening moves. Normally, you would want to move your pawn up two squares. Of course, I'm white, so I'll go first. Pretty much any of the pawns in front of your king or queen or bishops are the ones that would mostly get moved first. And you want to move them up two squares to gain the center board. Now the pawn controls these two squares. Any piece that moves here is in threat of being captured. You wouldn't want to move your pawn here, because you just pretty much lost that piece, unless that's part of your strategy. So I would move my piece here. And usually one of the early moves is to respond with either the same kind of positioning. Perhaps only moving one. But we'll start with the same. From here, I would not move my pawn here, because then your pawn would capture mine. So I will leave my pawn here, and perhaps I might move this pawn up. But most likely I will move this knight here, as my goal would be to attack that pawn. And of course, you might answer by moving your knight here and attacking my pawn if I attack yours, or moving a pawn here so that if I did attack this pawn, you could capture with that pawn. Or you could simply leave that pawn be, and if I were to capture it, you could counter with your queen capturing. And your queen would be no threat of being captured this early in the game. So you can see there are so many variations on playing the game, opening moves. One opening move can lead to so many different variations and end games, or middle games. Middle games is pretty much the middle of the game. End game is usually leading up to checkmate or stalemate. There are many different ways to set up the board. For positioning. And I'm just showing you some examples. There's really no right way or wrong way to play the game. But that is pretty much the game. Of chess, a lot of it is about protecting your king while advancing to attack the other opponent's king. check. King escapes check. Of course, you may not necessarily want to sacrifice the queen that early in the game, but again, so many variations, so many ways to win. And also, like any other game or competitive game, it is also somewhat psychological. If you know the tendencies of a certain player, you may want to be unorthodox. You may want to show certain moves to keep the other person thinking what they might expect you to do, and then you do something unexpected. Maybe you know someone that plays the same way over and over. Well, then you can work on doing a different kind of strategy, perhaps. But no matter how you play, it should all be for fun. We should all be good sports with each other. Remember to shake hands when you begin. Wish each other luck. May the best man or woman win. And then try to play your best. Learn from your mistakes. There are lots of resources online. Lots of chess apps. Online chess games. And of course, lots of examples of chess games that have been played by many experienced players. Whether grandmasters that have played the game in major world tournaments, you can learn from their moves. But again, so many different ways of playing and winning. So, that's really the game of chess in a nutshell. If you're just starting out, try not to be intimidated. Anybody else. Try not to get frustrated or discouraged. Like with any game, we all have to start and learn somewhere. So I want to thank you for joining me. I hope you found this somewhat relaxing. And maybe educational, informative. Maybe you've learned a couple things. So thank you for coming. I hope you enjoy this. And maybe next time I'll actually walk through a game of chess that was played by one of the grandmasters. Or, you know, of course, two of the grandmasters, I guess, in an actual tournament. Go through move by move, perhaps. Okay, my friends. Until next time, take care.